Welcome guys, welcome to another video of mine, and I've got a guest today, or two guests in fact. I don't know which one's got more brains here, but we're going to find out. Welcome Monkee Airsoft, otherwise known as And. And welcome our new friend Keith here today as well. So today we're going to be testing glasses. We see a lot of glasses out there on the market, from very, very cheap to, you know, quite fairly expensive ones. So we've got a range of glasses here today that we're going to test. So what we're going to be doing, Anand?
We've got seven different pairs of glasses that we're going to try and shoot, ranging from the mesh that everyone complains about to fan-assisted full goggles. And we're going to see what happens when you shoot them with a normal assault rifle and a sniper rifle.
Yeah, basically we're going to be doing the assault rifle on this side, the left-hand side, as you're looking, and the right-hand side we're going to be using the sniper rifle. You're going to be using 0.25 BBs in the rifle, and we're going to be using 0.45s in the sniper rifle. Now, here's a bone of contention, which I know some of you in the comments might already say, is we are going to be within minimum engagement difference, but this is to test sort of worst case scenario, something going off, someone running around a corner, going off in your face, seeing if these glasses can help your eyes survive, basically.
Okay, in the interest of information, what FPS are those guns currently shooting?
Roughly around about 340 for the Ares, and it's an Ares Octarms 15 inch, and then I've got the Ares Striker, and that's going to be shooting at around about 420 FPS today.
Kind of like Ares, don't you?
Yeah. I ain't got as much money as you, you Tokyo Marui's.
I eat more pot noodles.
Right, so let's get on with the testing.
Right, well, in terms of starting, a lot of people use kind of mesh and full goggles over spectacles, so might as well start with spectacles.
There we go. Okay, so here's our first set of glasses. Which ones were these, And?
These were my actual spectacles. They're Friends Connection UK. Quite expensive, I think they were about £500.
Right.
They've got reaction lenses. If you're an optometrist or an optician, the right eye is a -3.25, the left is a -2.5. How's that for science?
Such a fucking geek.
I can't tell lenses, I have to know which one to put in which, otherwise I end up blind. So, right, see how many shots it takes to actually hit it.
So, are we reckon it's going to break or not?
I think the frames are going to go before the lenses.
Okay.
Yeah. I think, if anything, the lens is going to fly out.
With this, and we're shooting the rifle first, and then we'll be shooting the striker next.
Yeah, disclaimer, the battery in the sight doesn't work, and the iron sight's about 3 inches off. Your foot's close enough to it.
That was a dry fire, I think.
Was it? Well, it wobbled.
Okay.
That's a pretty definitive result.
Here comes the striker. Missed.
Okay.
I don't think you have an eye left after that shot.
No.
Don't use those for airsofting.
Shit.
Okay, so this was the shots from the striker. Can you see the glass there embedded into the mannequin's eyebrows? I'm gonna say that's really not good. Don't use those for airsofting.
I guess I'm not using them for the way home either.
No. So Anne, this was another set of glasses you kindly brought down. What were these ones?
These are real 3D glasses, free at the cinema when I went to see The Force Awakens.
I really don't have much hope for these.
Nope.
Okay, here we go.
Right. First thing Keith can hope for is if I miss. And I didn't. That's just gone straight through.
It just went straight through. Yeah. That yeah, complete fail.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't use 3D glasses for airsoft.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Has that gone straight through the...
Yeah, we'll put it on that one. Yeah, as you can see, Keith has a rather large hole just under his left eye now.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, here we have... what do we have here? So we have some Tugu airsoft goggles, tactical paintball clear glasses. This is the description, the item description. These cost £1.45 of your hard-earned pennies from Amazon. So here we go with this test.
Anything that's £1.45 on Amazon is going to be crap.
Yeah, I don't think we predict high for this one.
That hits.
Oh, please do that again, please, and. Okay, I don't think Anne's missing here, so just do a third.
No, the head's moving.
Yeah, they are actually surviving. I think we're getting some little scuff marks on the screen. Let me just try and zoom in here.
That is unexpected.
But yeah. Well, let's see how the strike goes. Well, didn't seem to go through.
Didn't seem to miss either. Definitely hit.
These two good glasses have just saved your eyesight, I think.
Oh, yeah, you can see the hit.
Yeah, I think you can see the scuff marks.
Yeah, they are definitely marked. But, yeah, they haven't gone through.
Yeah, that was a positive test.
I am genuinely surprised.
£1.45 of your hard-earned pennies there, saving your eyesight.
Yeah.
There we go, on to the next. On to the next set. We've just got some PNG protective glasses here. Now these were £3.21 from Taiwan Gun, so which is a pretty cheap retailer from Poland. Yep. So yeah, let's see how these do.
Okay, glasses off.
I don't know whether you're going into his cheek bit there actually on the last
one. I think the last one.
Yeah. Try again, just do one more a bit higher. Scuffs. That's really good plastic that. Right. See how it holds up against the striker. You doing alright, Keith? Yeah? Glasses actually moving off that dummy.
Oh, look at the shape of the frame.
I know. Oh, there we go.
Yep, there's a result.
So they'll last a little bit and then they'll fall apart on you. And then you'll have nothing. Yeah, I wouldn't give them a great result, to be fair, not if they're going to fall apart on you like that in the middle of the field.
Oh, in fairness. No, no, I thought I'd fix them. Right, they're terrible.
On to the next set. Now, I wear a set of these for most of my airsofting, so I'm really hoping these do okay. These are the Bowl Track PSI Tracker Safety Goggles with vents, and these are £7.60 off Amazon, so let's see how these do. We're going to do a couple more shots.
Actually, were.
That survived pretty well.
See a bit of scuffing on the framework there, but apart from that, not a lot.
Right, let's see how they do against the striker.
Some scuff marks. Yeah.
Okay. Overall, seem to stand up well.
Pretty heavy duty scuff marks there, I can see on the front.
Yeah. I mean, the sniper's done quite a few scuff marks. The assault rifle doesn't really seem to have done anything.
So, yeah. Huh. Good. Right, I'm glad I wear these for airsoft, isn't it? Here's our next set of goggles. These are some CS steel mesh goggles. Mod 2 in coyote colour. And these are £2.49 from Taiwan Gun. Now, I've got a serious problem with mesh. I mean, I don't know your thoughts, Anne, but I really don't trust mesh at all.
Yeah, I mean, even if the glasses hold up, the chances of shards of BB going through are just not worth the risk.
I mean, I'm hoping that we might see. What I predict, basically, is I think a BB is going to shatter in there, if it does shatter at all. And then those bits, when we pull the glasses off, you might see some shattering coming out, you know, basically, from underneath the goggles.
Yeah, or potentially paint flex off the painted mesh.
Yeah, I just don't trust mesh stuff, basically. But here we go, let's see what they do. Doesn't seem too bad.
Yeah.
I think the BBs are breaking up, but I don't think anything's probably going in the middle of them. I think you've dented them slightly.
Yeah. Well, should we full auto them as well?
Go for it. His nose gone.
Keith, what's happened to your nose?
Looks like he's got a bad cocaine habit. Okay, so on to the striker. What are you seeing, Ann? Anything?
I'm seeing a big chunk out of his cheek where you just missed.
Okay.
see, that seems to fragment.
Yeah. I'm definitely seeing some denting in that mesh.
Right.
Let me do one more.
Oh.
Let me do one more.
Yeah. Yeah, up close it looks a little bit different.
Right.
Yeah, that's not good.
Yeah, that's really not good. I think we're going to have to get a close-up shot on this one. Look at that denting. I would not want that in front of my eyeballs. Right, Anne, will you just lift up the front and
see if anything comes? Oh, something came out.
Yeah.
Shard of BB.
Yeah, that's not good.
Might have been a shard of Keith. Either way, it's not a good thing. No, there is visible bits of BB on the inside.
There we go.
To be fair though, I expected the paint to hang on. Yeah, it's actually completely broken at the bottom as well.
Oh, there we go.
Yep, don't recommend.
Here's our next set. And you brought these. What were these again?
Yeah, these are a pair of Block Action Sport sunglasses. I think I paid about £100 for them at the time, so they're not a cheap brand. They are designed for action sports like skiing, so I'm expecting they should take a hit, but I don't know.
Let's see, let's find out.
Some definite something there.
That's like, I don't know if you can catch that on the screen, but there's definitely some bubbling or something happening to the front of the glass there. So yeah,
give it a couple more shots, Sam. Let's see if it gets worse.
Oh yeah, there we go. That's definitely worse.
If I just put this up.
Come on, you're gonna focus any time today.
Oh, I think I forgot to put this camera on for that one.
Yeah, definitely done some damage.
Alright, let's see what the striker does.
Some
thing. There you see, a big scuff mark, I think. Yeah.
Surviving better than with
your sock. One more. Yeah. I'm not too sure.
I'm
not too unhappy with that.
Well, it's got. Oh, hang on. Yeah, I think the problem might have been with the assault rifle, that it hit the frame.
Hit the frame and bust the frame.
Yeah.
Here's our last set of the day, I believe. And what were these again? I'm just sorry.
The FMA fan goggles.
There you go. From Taiwan Gun again, and these were £17.14.
And we both have a pair of these, so fingers crossed they're all right.
Fingers crossed, right? Let's see what the rifle can do.
Scuff marks, that's it.
Yeah.
Surviving. Give it a blast on
four. Okay. Yeah. Again, a lot of scuffs, but did well.
Yeah.
Remember, because this is one piece of glass as well, this is going to affect both sides, really, you know, for weakness.
Oh, yeah, good point.
There we go with a striker. Scuff marks again, but apart from that, no damage, I don't think. Yeah, happy with those. Right, so we're doing all our testing, and what do you think?
I was actually surprised at how respectable some of the cheap ones were.
Yeah.
And how bad some of the others were.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think our winner, basically, is this set, which is, that's my set that I wear. And, you know, they seem to have the less scuff marks on, didn't they? They just seem to survive the best, and I'd still be happy for the price buying those every time, as both of our top rated glasses.
Yeah, I mean, I've previously had a pair and only got rid because I found the fogged a bit too much.
Yeah.
Because I'm a sweaty dude.
Yeah. So what was our worst in hand?
The worst were the 3D glasses. You might as well put paper over your eyes. They were completely useless.
I reckon I can poke my finger through here. No, not quite that one. I don't know. Oh yeah, they just pop out.
I think you need practice at that.
Don't wear them. What was our next worst?
Next worst were my actual glasses that are now absolutely buggered. One lens is completely gone, the other lens is just annihilated.
Yeah.
So, yeah, don't think that these under some terrible eye pro is going to save you, because it's probably going to do you more harm than good.
Yeah, with the shards, that was so amazing to see the shards of glass in the dummy's head. That was amazing to see that, because that's going to do some serious damage to your flesh.
Yep, but rather this dummy than another dummy.
Exactly. Yeah. What was our next worst?
The shooting glasses.
The shooting glasses, yeah, these things. Just falling apart in the middle, you know. That was just after the rifle, without even the striker hitting them, I think.
Yeah.
Oh,
no, it was the striker that made them explode.
Sorry, the striker, yeah, but they did start to warp, didn't they, before with the rifle. Yeah, I just... For the £3 odd, I think there's better products down here in a minute.
Well, you could get two or three pairs of something else.
Exactly, so yeah, I think they're going to be going in the bin.
Yep. Right, next worst were the block sunglasses. yeah, they're not designed for airsoft or anything like that. If something isn't designed and rated for airsoft, just don't.
Yeah, just useless. The fact they lose a lens is just terrible, but you know, I mean, at least one of them didn't break, you know, and or at least explode in your face.
Yeah, so worst case scenario, you look like Nick Fury.
Exactly. Next ones, these ones, which I think we said a lot about while we were testing them as well, but because we both just don't like mesh, do we?
Yeah.
And that just proves it for me. Why do not wear mesh? I just, that's just terrible.
I mean, to be fair, they did better than I was expecting until we actually took them off the mannequin and there was bits of BB falling out. I mean, that is concerning.
Exactly, and I know it was extreme with the striker, but that denting with the 0.45 BBs, just denting that mesh, I just, don't like them at all. So there we go, in the bin as well. What was next?
Right, next up, we're actually into the decent stuff.
Yeah.
So, next up, the FMA fan goggles. The assault rifle did mark it, but not that bad.
Not terrible.
The sniper did put some significant marks on. As we said when we were testing them, both of us have a pair of these. And yeah, I mean, I would happily wear them
after this.
I have removed the foam from mine because they're supposed to not fog, but if they've got foam in, they're just...
That's why I put them in for the test there, because they even come for that £17 with a spare set of lenses, with a spare glass. This was the black glass or the greyed out glass that I've put in for the test, because I'll use mostly the clear glass. But for that, I'm really happy with. So they're going to be really good, I think. So happy with those.
Yeah. The only other gripe, while we're on it though, they need to extend this wire.
Oh God, yeah.
It doesn't reach a counterweight pouch
on the round helmet. Round a helmet just does not, it's just pants.
I'm going to have to rewire mine and put longer.
But for £17.
Yeah, you can't complain.
No.
Oh, well, we just
So our next, without the winner, or our runner-up, I should say, I think has to be, what was it, £1.34 or something, silly?
I think it was £1.20 something.
It's £1.20 something, but I'm sorry, but these are our star player. I mean, these are the winners, but these just...
Yeah, genuinely surprised that they were as decent as they were.
You know,
I expected those to just explode.
I mean, you might not get a great amount of comfort out of these. The foam is not brilliant. You're not going to be able to see that from this distance, but and they do have a strap, but I mean, for £1 odd, you can't complain of that. I'll be quite happy to lend them to a friend or something, or use them myself and know that they're going to have be safe, basically. So
I mean, you could always replace the foam around the outside with something a little bit more substantial, a little bit comfier, but as a spare, just having your bag in case your primary eye pro goes down.
Decent vent holes in them.
Yeah,
that's definitely a good one. Right, so I think that's about it for the video.
Yeah,
we hope you liked it, and well, please let us know any comments on what you think we fucked up on, or whether you think we did all right, basically. And we'll move on to the next one. Go check out Anne's channel. I mean, we're going to try and put this across both channels, I think. But yeah, check it all out. All right. Thanks a lot. Great. Thanks for watching.